friends, what's up? Today's video is going to be my July wrap-up, and I read a lot of books, so let's get right on into this. So I did already post my Bibliothon wrap-up. It is partially the day 9 vlog, and then the end of it is the whole wrap-up. So I'll link that up above in the cards just in case you want to check that out to get more details on the books that I read that month. But the books that I read for that week were Aurora Rising, Daisy Jones and the Six, We Are Here Forever, Inkmistress. Lastly, I also read Girls on the Verge. So if you want to hear more of my thoughts on all of those books, then check out that video up above because I won't go into details of any of those in this video. I read another 5 books on top of those 5, and I'm in the middle of 2 other books. So that is how many books I've read. 10 books in July plus 2 I'm currently in the middle of. I think this is my best reading month yet, which the Bibliothon always does this to me. Usually, at least. Of the books that were on my TBR this month, and I am going to include my Bibliothon TBR in this as well. So of the books that I had on my TBR, I read, then I also read an additional 2 books, and I'm in the middle of another additional 2 books. I only read 1 adult novel. I read 7 young adult novels, and you know me, if you've been watching my wrap-ups for a while, I try to keep a good half and half split between adult and young adult, and obviously this month, that did not happen. I also read what I consider to be 1 children's book. I just unbuttoned my shirt. Hello. I don't really know where this one lands on this, on like what it's considered in the industry, but I consider it a children's novel. 2 contemporaries, 2 sci-fis, 3 fantasies, and 2 historical fictions. So I had quite a range as far as my genres go, which I love that. I read 1 physical book, 5 audiobooks, 2 ebooks, and 1 graphic novel. So if you put all of them together, I read 4 books physically that weren't all novels, and then I read 5 audiobooks, so that is more standard of half and half. If you remember my June haul, I mean wrap up, I read like only audiobooks, and so I'm definitely getting the hang of reading while not at work thing, so that is very nice. I read 4 3-star novels, 2 4-star novels, and 3 5-star novels. So again, very mixed in the bag as far as star ratings go, and then I also want to talk about the 2 I'm currently reading. My page count, not including the 2 books I'm in the middle of, I have read 3,072 pages this month, which is pretty high for me. I think that's my highest page count yet in this year. This has been a really good reading month. Firstly, I read Someday We Will Fly by Rachel DeWoskin, and this book was sent to me unsolicited by Penguin. This is a book, it's a historical fiction about a girl who is from Poland and she's a Jew, and this takes place during Nazi Germany, and so they are starting to look at Poland and take Jews out of their homes, and her dad and her little sister leave the country and go to I believe it's Hong Kong. Oh, Shanghai in China, because it's one of the last places that are taking in Jews and Polish people. But in China, they also are dealing with the Japanese taking over basically at the same time. Our main character is like, I think she's supposed to be 16, but she read really young. She read like she was like 11. And I also found this is very much like a character-driven book, and there's not a whole lot of plot going on, and I didn't care about her. Like I said, she read really young, and it felt weird to be reading her because she's like doing a lot of things that are like already like inappropriate for a 16-year-old or whatever. She's like doing what she has to do to survive. But then how young she read, I was just like, this feels weird, and I just didn't vibe with it. I also had an issue with the little sister's character. The little sister is like supposed to be 3 or 4, and from the very beginning there's this like conversation that this little girl like isn't speaking at the time that she should be. She's like basically mute and like doesn't speak yet, and then when they move to China, she like picks up Chinese really easily, which from my linguistic background made no sense whatsoever to me because the little girl spends her entire time with her dad who doesn't speak Chinese, and then her sister who is like learning some words in Chinese but mostly speaks Polish, and they speak Polish at home but yet she's learning Chinese easily. Like, that's not how language acquisition works. So, what? That was like really distracting to me. It fell flat. Basically, it just wasn't the book for me. I gave it a 2.5 stars. The next book I want to talk about really quickly is Aurora Rising, which was the group book for the Bibliothon, and it also was my challenge for a predicted 5-star read. Unfortunately, I only gave this a 3.5 out of 5 stars. I found that the characters were lacking again, and they all read very, like, flat. Like, they weren't developed enough. So that was my problem with this one. Same with Inkmistress by Audrey Coulthurst. This was the Sassy Book Club pick for the month of July. We did a live show on Chelsea's channel. I will link that up in the cards above, and obviously we talked in full detail about this, but it is spoilery. And then I also talked about it in that Bibliothon wrap-up as well. I gave this a 3.5 out of 5 stars. I just didn't like some of the decision-making that happened with these characters. I felt like our characters forgot a lot of what other characters like have done betrayal wise, and we just like didn't get through that. We just like skipped over it and let it go, and I'm like, no, I didn't like that. So that's my next book that I had. And then I also read this month The Weight of the Stars by K.A. Engram. This was the Sassy Book Club pick for May, and we did a live show on my channel at the beginning of June, so I will also link that one up above. And if you're interested in getting all of the details about that, you can check that one out. This book follows a girl who is obsessed with space. Her name is Ryan. She comes from like a poor background. Her parents are out of the picture. Her and her brother, who's like a young adult, take care of each other basically. And he has a child who's very young. And they just kind of like help each other out. And it's very much a found family situation. There's another girl named Alexandria whose mom left when she was a very young baby and went out to space and like is on a space experiment travel thing that will never come back. And like, in theory, this whole book was really interesting, but it just fell flat for me. Again, I don't know. I'm being very picky this month apparently, but I just didn't find the character decisions realistic. I gave this book a 3 out of 5 stars as well. But getting into some of my 4-star novels, one of the books that I read for the Bibliothon was We Are Here Forever by Michelle Gish. My challenge for reading a graphic novel as well as The Author You've Never Read. And this is like a series of short stories in graphic novel format about these little alien things called Paramus, and they have taken over Earth and the humans no longer exist, and they're just like these cute little adorable things. But as you continue reading, you find out that maybe they are not so simple themselves, and perhaps they are the reason for the destruction of humans. That's what this book is about. I gave it a 4 out of 5 stars. This is the one that I kind of consider a children's book, but also the topics were like pretty adult if you really think about it. But like, I don't know, I think it's a children's book in my opinion, and I think that the like deeper topics are meant for the parent who has to help the child read it, if you get what I mean. And that's that. I talked way more about it in that Bibliothon wrap-up that I keep mentioning. Next, I read Crown of Midnight by Sarah J. Maas. This is the second book in the Throne of Glass series. Me and Brittany's book find are reading one book a month for the rest of this year, and we're doing live shows about it. The live show for Crown of Midnight was on Brittany's channel, so I will link that up above as well. Brittany's channel is also linked down there. We also have a Twitter for the TOG read-along, which is at TOG read-alongs with an S at the end. If you want to check that out and get information for each of our live shows, that's where you can find all of that. 4 out of 5 stars for me. This was a reread. The first two books in this series are just okay for me, and then I'm so excited to read Air of Fire, which was on my TBR for this month, but I have not gotten to it, and it's July 31st as the day I'm filming it. Happy birthday to Harry Potter, and so I will be reading that next month. But I'm so excited to get to the rest of this series. This was good, but it was not fantastic. It's definitely still like setting up where we're headed. The end of this book is always the best part. I'm so ready for Air of Fire. Moving on to some amazing five-star books I've read. Firstly, I read Daisy Jones and the Sixth by Taylor Jenkins Reid. This was the challenge for reading an adult book as well as reading a book based on the cover, and this was amazing. I listened to this on audiobook. The one thing that I do say is a little bit detrimental to this is that, like, you kind of have to read it in audiobook format in order for it to be good. I don't think it stands well on its own physically. Have I read it physically? No, but I think that it would not have been as good if I had, and I think that that's kind of a detriment to its amazingness, but I did really enjoy it a lot. During the Bibliothon, I also read Girls on the Verge, and this was phenomenal. Again, 5 out of 5 stars. Again, I talked a lot about this in that Bibliothon video, but I really loved this. I highly recommend. I also made an art thing based on this for a Bibliothon challenge, which will be linked. Lastly, I read Night of Cake and Puppets by Lainey Taylor, which was the novella that goes along with the Daughter of Smoke and Bone series. Me and Katrina and Red were reading these books together, and so there is a live show on Katrina's channel for this book, and us just kind of talking a lot about how much we love Zuzana and Mick, which are two characters that are in the Daughter of Smoke and Bone series as, like, not main characters, but like secondary characters, and they are amazing. This book was so cute and adorable, and I really highly recommend reading it physically. I actually listened to it on audiobook, but I recommend the physical one because there are illustrations. Lainey Taylor wrote it, and her husband illustrated it, and like, it's just a cute little love story, and I feel like it's a love story about them even though it's not, and it's so cute. And that's all I have to say about that. The only other two things I want to talk about quickly are the two books that I'm in the middle of. I'm currently reading The Gatekeeper's Sons by Eva Poehler. I was sent this in exchange for an honest review, so I am listening to it on audiobook. I'm about 2/3 of the way in. I'm actually hoping that I will finish this today, if not tomorrow. I'm unfortunately not entirely loving it. Some things about this I really love. It is a book about a girl who is 16 and the god of death, Thanatos, he takes a liking to her, and so does his brother Hypnos, which is the god of sleep. These two are twins and sons of Hades, the god of the underworld, and all of the Greek mythology that is in this I think is really well done. I really love all of the, like, characterizations of all of these gods. I think that that's fantastic. I feel like she really did a lot of research on, like, getting those things right. My detriment for this book so far has really been the fact that this is supposed to take place in present day, and we're dealing with teenagers who don't use cell phones and call each other on their home phones to ask them to go dancing or to the movies. And I'm like, are we in 1950? Because this doesn't seem like real teenagers in this time frame. And, like, I know it's set in real time, like, in present day, because of the references some of them make. Like, they'll talk about Lady Gaga every once in a while. So, like, worst case, we're talking about a few years ago, but, like, not old enough for them to be calling each other on their home phones. It's weird. I also, this book deals with parent death, so there is a trigger warning for that. Our main character's parents die at the beginning of this novel, and that's kind of, like, where the story starts. And I don't feel like our character is really dealing with any of that grief, and, like, is very hellbent on being in love, and I'm just like, girl, your parents just died. And, like, I feel like she's more sad about the horse that dies in this book than about her parents who died in this book. So there are some things. I'm going to finish it so that I can give it a full review. So keep an eye out for that. I'll definitely be reviewing it on Goodreads, and then it'll be in my wrap-up. And then I'm also reading I'll Give You the Sun by Jandy Nelson, and this book has taken me by surprise. I did not know I was gonna love this as much as I'm loving it. You can see this is all I have left. This book is, like, hard hitting, man. There's also parent death in this. There's, like, a lot of shit in this. And ooh-wee. I, like, don't even know how to explain this book. It's kind of a contemporary and kind of a paranormal, because our main character, the female twin Jude, sees her grandma and her mom as ghosts, and, like, she talks to them and they talk back, and, like, they're very prevalent in the story. But, like, are we dealing with mental health or are we dealing with actual paranormal stuff? it's like kind of written where you are just living in this like suspended reality, and I really, really enjoy it. I'm so stressed reading this book though. I've had a hard time picking it up, but then once I do pick it up, I'm like devouring it. But like when I put it down, I'm like, I don't know if I want to read this because it's like, it's hard, but I love it at the same time. So the books that I'm currently reading, those are all the books that I read in July. I cannot believe I had such a good reading month. I cannot believe the Bibliothon is over. The Bibliothon is never happening ever again. That's very sad. I don't even know what's happening anymore, but yeah, so that's everything I have for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Please give it a thumbs up if you did. I make videos every Thursday and Saturday. Please make sure to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. I also leave all my social media links down below if you're interested. I have some affiliate links down there. I am now an affiliate for the YA Book of the Month book. So if you want to check that out, there's an August code it down there for you to get like a cheaper subscription fee for the first month that you sign up with my code. There's also a Book of the Month non-affiliate referral link down there where you can get a free book with your subscription if you want to do the adult ones. That's really cool, and I'm gonna say bye now. Bye!